Got blocked by a mutual friend for internalized fat phobia. Cause I said I wanted to lose weight. I'll finish that sentence. I'm an awful fat phobic person. Just kidding, your mutual friend is an awful person for even getting mad at you for wanting to lose weight. How is that internalized fat phobia? What's going on, Moderchodes? It's your boy Long Neil back again with another new video, and in today's video we're going over the hot posts from r/fatlogic. Let's get into it. We all have a thin friend who eats whatever they like, never exercises, and doesn't gain weight. Yet it's so impossible for the opposite to be true. Okay, so we all probably have a friend that has a better metabolism than us. Fair enough. But to say that they eat whatever they like and never exercise and don't gain weight is a bit misleading, because oftentimes these people that seem like they eat whatever they want and don't exercise are often either A, under eaters, and when they do eat, they eat junk food, but small amounts of it, and you see that and go, well, they eat whatever they want. But the difference is when they eat the junk food, they eat a reasonable portion size, and when you eat it, you eat the whole bag. Like, it's different. Or B, they're just more active than you. Doesn't have to be going to the gym. It could be something as simple as playing pickup basketball, or gardening, or walking their dogs. Anything like that that burns calories, that makes them more active than you, who just sits at home all day on their computer. Like, there's so many different factors into this, so to say that you know their life that well, that they eat whatever they like and never exercise and don't gain weight, their metabolism probably isn't that much better than yours. They just have better habits. That's it. Dear my skinny friends, what are you actively doing to unlearn the gaze that renders fat folks unattractive? This is not a rhetorical question. Let's stop pretending that our non-desires are simply preferences and not culturally informed, or as if they were just a given fact that one can't influence. If your idea of body positivity stops at simply not actively shaming fat folks, I call it doesn't go far enough. Okay, so basically now you're just getting mad at me for not being attracted to certain people. Like, sorry, I can't help that. I don't find somebody who's 400 pounds and can barely walk attractive. There are some people that do, and to them, that's awesome. And I hope they meet each other and live happily ever after. But you can't force me to be attracted to people that I find unattractive. And I don't even know why you would want to in the first place. Like, if you're trying to convince me that you're attractive, maybe, just maybe, it's not gonna work out between us. According to BMI, an inaccurate and misleading scale, I am obese. Yet, I have no physical health issues to speak of. I run 3 times a week and completed a half marathon in March. Looking at someone and deciding they're unhealthy doesn't make it fact. It just makes you judgmental. Actually, yes, you can tell if someone is unhealthily obese by sight. People are free to feel good about themselves, but it's not a good idea for everyone else to lie to them. And no one said they were any less worthy of love, etc. Now, back to your pathetic virtue signaling. couldn't have said it much better myself. And by the way, the fact that you completed a half marathon doesn't necessarily mean you're in good shape or healthy. It just means you are able to walk for 13.1 miles. Like, basically, 99% of the population can complete a half marathon if they wanted to. Now, if you said, I completed a half marathon in 2 hours, then I'd be pretty impressed. But I have a feeling that it took you 4+ hours. So I'm not impressed. I can't help being fat. People like you make people like me cry ourselves to sleep at nights. What? You can't help being fat? What's stopping you from getting skinny? I'm pretty sure it's only 2 things. Your unhealthy eating habits and your lack of exercise. If you're really crying yourself to sleep at night because of your weight, then maybe, just maybe, you should try exercising more and track your calories so that you're in a caloric deficit and lose weight. Because that's all it takes. Now, I'm not happy that you're crying yourself to sleep at night, because obviously you're struggling, and I don't like to see anybody struggling. But to say that you can't help being fat is just a straight up lie. Like, ugh. Hundreds of years of evolution have created this container that's perfect for me. Out of respect for my ancestors, I want to honor this body as an extension of them. My ancestry is way more powerful than mainstream beauty standards. Yeah, evolution definitely isn't the reason that you're 400 pounds. It might have something to do with the fact that you take a family-sized bag of chips and treat it like it's an individual-sized bag of chips and eat it all in one sitting. And then do that with every other food you eat. I don't know. I could be completely wrong. I guess it really could be your ancestors passing down their excess fat. And everybody from the last 10 generations just happened to give all their fat to you. Woohoo! Lucky you! You're a big winner! I'm sure your ancestors will be proud. I got something to say, but I'll keep it short and sweet. This whole body positive movement looks a lot like skinny shaming lately. Offended by thin or fit women loving their bodies, wearing certain things, showing their booty gains on the gram? But you're literally screaming, "Yas, queen," for Lizzo in a yellow leather onesie, shaking her booty on stage and everywhere else, which I am so here for, by the way. Sweetie has stamina, like, whoa. But what? No, not how this works, y'all. You don't get to call the celebration of certain body types vanity while calling the celebration of others a movement. It's time to stop fueling the agenda with hate and insecurity. I'm way over it. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk. Exactly. Just because somebody's skinny doesn't mean that they shouldn't be part of the body positive movement. The whole thing about this movement is that it's inclusive to all bodies. Like, what? You're literally excluding certain types of people when you try to kick them out of your body positive movement, which breaks the whole purpose of the movement. What are you thinking? The hardest part is understanding that no matter how much I love and accept myself, I live in a system that dehumanizes me. This isn't about self-love. This is oppression. P.S. Health doesn't determine a human's worth. Okay, obviously health doesn't determine a human's worth. Plenty of other things do that. So let's move on. We all knew that to begin with. The fact that you're saying you're oppressed and using it to compare yourself to, I don't know, let's say people that are actually oppressed is a bit ridiculous. Like, no, the fact that you're fat is an oppression. Nobody's oppressing you for that. Guess what? If you don't want to be so-called oppressed, all you have to do is be in a calorie deficit. And then, whoa, just like that, your so-called oppression goes away. But people that are really oppressed can't just change the way they look. So, yeah, guess what? You're out of your mind for saying that you're oppressed. Weight loss isn't a victory. Weight loss isn't a positive goal or a happy accident. Celebrating weight loss is a product of diet culture, even if you weren't dieting to lose weight. If you say you are body positive but are ecstatic about losing weight, diet culture still has a hold over how you perceive people's bodies and the fat on them. Why can't we just let people be happy for bettering their life and getting healthier? And, I don't know, looking better. Like, this has nothing to do with you. If you're that insecure that people celebrating their own weight loss makes you feel bad about yourself, maybe you should do something about it and go on a diet. It's really not that hard. Let these people be happy for the things they've accomplished. Medical fat phobia in a nutshell. Weight is not a choice and/or correlated with health, but fat patients are treated as though they choose to neglect their health and thus receive inadequate healthcare, are scared off from making an appointment, and are told to change their body type before treatment so that their life will be worth saving. Okay, so literally, when you're obese, you are neglecting your health, clearly, because it's been proven that obesity is not healthy. And also, a lot of times, you have to lose weight because anesthesia is very hard to manage for heavier people. So if you're going to be put under, they're actually trying to give you a higher chance of survival by telling you to lose weight. So they do care about your life. And if any doctor is telling you that your life isn't worth saving just because you're overweight, go to a different doctor because they're just an awful person. And I really think that isn't happening that much. But if it is, switch doctors. Give yourself permission to grieve your smaller body and the clothes that no longer fit. And then get rid of that junk. It's your clothes job to fit you, not your job to fit the clothes. It's easy to underestimate the grieving process of a changing body, but it's real and it's an important part of healing. And when you're feeling ready, let those clothes go. And let's also recognize that being able to access clothes in your size or afford new ones is a privilege that not everyone has. What? So now we're just expecting our clothes to morph into larger sizes because we gained weight? How about instead of throwing out your clothes, you, I don't know, lose some weight and fit back in those clothes? Like, oh my God, these people are out of their minds. What is going on? It's not your job to fit the clothes. Whose job is it? It's obviously not the clothes' job. Oh my God, these people are whacked. We're gonna end this one with this quote. If you don't do what's best for your body, you're the one who comes up on the short end. Julius Irving. So basically, you can lie to yourself all you want and say that you're healthy at 400 pounds. But guess what? That lie is only going to come back to bite you in the butt in the long run. So maybe treat yourself better, take care of your health, and your future self will thank you for it. All right, Modern Chodes, that's it for the hot post from r/fatlogic. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. And of course, share this video with your friends. Till next time, peace.